Hello friends and welcome back to Clarie Concepts. In this series of kinematics and theory of machines, today we are going to see introduction of mechanisms and machines. Flowchart of machine, mechanisms, machines and its difference, rigid body and non-rigid body, rigid body and resistant body, kinematic link and classification or types of kinematic link. Flowchart of machine. Now, what do I mean by flowchart of machine? It means that how a machine is formed. We will see step by step. So first, there is a rigid body or resistant body. Then from that rigid body, a kinematic link is formed. Then from kinematic link, we will make a kinematic pair. Then from that pair, there will be a kinematic chain. Then we'll get a mechanism by doing some things inside kinematic chain. We will see that what changes has to be done in kinematic chain to obtain mechanism. And finally, there is a machine, right? So therefore, I am calling this as a flow chart or simply steps. We have to understand each and every concept associated or whatever you can see on the screen right now to completely understand machine and mechanism both, right? So we will see by the example, what do I mean by all of these? So first of all, here there is a simple rod which I am saying that it is a kinematic link. Now in the coming slides, we have to further study in detail what is rigid body and so on and so forth till machine. So right now I am not defining what do we mean by kinematic link. Then from this, we are making a pair. That means there are two kinematic links. We are joining them and I am calling it now a kinematic pair. Then I am making it as a chain, closed chain, and calling that as a kinematic chain. Now further, in that kinematic chain, there is some fundamental difference or modification to obtain a mechanism. And that mechanism, now the example here, I am taking it as slider crank mechanism. And that slider crank mechanism will be used inside IC engine. Now this is a machine, right? So we have seen how a kinematic link is used to make a pair and then chain, then mechanism to machine, right? Now we will see all of these concepts in detail. Before studying all these concepts in detail, we should know exactly what do we mean by mechanism, what is machine and its fundamental difference. So a mechanism is a combination of number of bodies assembled in such a way that the motion of one causes constrained and predictable motion to the others is known as mechanism, right? So by the definition, it may not be clear to you. I will use some examples to elaborate this. Now let's say this is a hand pump and I am saying that it is a mechanism. It is an example of mechanism. Now in this mechanism, the important part is motion of one causes predictable motion to others. That means some motion transmission is taking place. So you can see in this example, this lever in the hand pump, we are giving input motion to this lever, and because of that, the output link, which you can see inside the pump or inside the shaft, which is pumping the water outside, right? So that motion of this red link or a sliding link is predictable. That means whenever I am taking the lever downside, the slider is going up. Whenever the lever is going up, the slider is going down, and this process is continuing. That means some motion is transmitted. So we can say that it is a mechanism. Next example is again. Now in this example, we are taking so many mechanisms. I am not giving you the names of the mechanism because we have to study these mechanisms in detail afterwards. Why they have used, where they have used, and what are the applications. Okay. Right now you just have to focus on the motion transmission. Now here in this example, you can see a green link which is transmitting its motion to the red link in some way or the other. So therefore it is a mechanism. Here this is the most useful mechanism that humankind have created, that is the gear mechanism, which transmits motion from one shaft to another shaft through teeth. In this example, you can see a car wiper, right? So there is a motor which is connected to a green link. That green link is rotating completely. That means it is rotating 360 degree, and the motion is transmitted such a way that the two links of the car wiper are oscillating. Right? Again, we are looking at motion transmission. So important point till now in all these examples is only motion transmission. Again, the last example we are going to see in this is Pisillier straight line mechanism. Again, this application part and why it is used, that is we are going to see in detail in the coming slides. Right now again you have to see the motion transmission from one link to another link is taken place. So whenever we call, or whenever there is a motion transmission from one link to another link, and that transmitted motion or the output motion is predictable, this one, then we will call that as a mechanism, right? Now we will see what are machines. Now here in this example, you can see so many parts are there and they are moving. That means one link is again transmitting motion from one part to another part, right? So I can also say that it is a mechanism. But what is the fundamental difference here? The fundamental difference is, apart from transmitting motion from one link to another link, there is some energy transmission. Now that is the difference in mechanism and machine. Mechanism only transmits motion, and while machine, along with transmission of motion, there is a transmission of energy from one part to another part, and the available mechanical energy is used to perform some desired work. Now this is a rotary engine, so we are going to use this available mechanical energy to perform some useful work, right? We will see another example of machine. So here you can see a press machine or a punching machine which is punching inside a plate, right? You can see over here one of the link is coming downwards and punching in the plate. So here again electrical energy is getting converted into mechanical energy, and it is doing some useful or desired work. So we can call this as a machine. That means apart from motion transmission, some desired output work is carried out, right? Now we will see the definition. It is a mechanism or combination of mechanisms. That means there can be one mechanism or more than one mechanism, which apart from imparting definite motion, the meaning of definite motion here is predictable motion, to the parts, also transmits and modifies the available mechanical energy into some kind of desired work. So there has to be desired work, and along with desired work, there has to be energy transmission. Then we will call this as a machine. Now here we will see difference in mechanism and machines using some examples. You can see a toy, clock, a chair, umbrella, folding lamp, and a scissors, right? So are all of them a mechanism or a machine? That we have to find out. So in the previous slides, we have seen that those which is only transmitting motion are known as mechanism, and those apart from transmitting motion, if some energy transmission is also carried out along with some output desired work, then we will call that thing as a machine. Now here in all these examples, only motion is transmitted from one link to another link. We will take the first example as scissors. So there is only a motion transmission from one link to another link. So this is a mechanism. In a clock, you can see a minute hand, a second hand, hour hand. So there is some mechanism which is moving these hands or rotating these hands. That means it is only transmitting motion, and that motion is predictable, of course. Next one is a chair. Again, in that folding chair, the motion is transmitted. In the umbrella also, motion is transmitted. No output work or no desired work is carried out in these both examples. The final one, folding lamp. We are not talking about the lamp itself. We are talking about the mechanism which is associated with it. That means the folding mechanism. So how we fold it? Using links. That means the motion of one link is transmitted to the other link. Therefore, it is a mechanism. To summarize, in this figure or in this slide, all the examples are of mechanisms. Now let us look at some more examples. First, we will see typewriter. Now in this typewriter, let's say you are pressing any letter. So because of that, what is going to happen? That is connected to a link. That link will move in some way, and that letter will be then typed on the paper. That means the motion is transmitted from one part to another part. There is no energy transmission. Make sure this. Now, whenever I say there is no energy transmission, then I cannot say that this is a machine. That means I will have to call this as a mechanism, right? Now, to make things more clear, now I am including an example in which there is a machine as well as mechanism, both. And now we will differentiate them. Now let's take the example of truck only initially. Now whether the truck can be called as mechanism or it is a machine. Now in a truck, first of all, motion transmission is there, yes. Then is there an energy transmission? Yes. What type of energy is transmitted? So chemical energy is converted into mechanical energy. Chemical energy in the form of fuel, and mechanical energy is in the form of rotation of shaft, and that rotation of shaft is then used to rotate these wheels, and then we use truck to commute from one point to another point. That means some desired output work is taken place. Therefore, truck is a machine, right? Now on that machine, let's say this is a dumping truck now. So the bin, I want to use that bin as a tilted bin, or I want that material inside this bin to be dumped outside, right? So there we have connected so many links. To be precise, there are 4 links. We are going to discuss how many links at least we should have to create a mechanism. So in this mechanism, only motion transmission is taken place so that this bin is tilted and the material or the goods inside this will be dumped outside, right? So this was example to just differentiate between a mechanism and a machine. Similarly, we can say that in this example, a car is there, car is again a machine, because apart from motion transmission, there is energy transmission, and that energy transmission is used to perform some desired work. Now, on that machine, we are using a car wiper, one of the mechanism out of many. So that car wiper, is it a mechanism or is it a machine now? In a car wiper, I am initially calling it as a mechanism, because only motion is transmitted from one part to another part. In the previous slides, I have shown you in the mechanisms that the motor is connected to one of the link, which is rotating 360 degree, and that is connected in such a way that to these two links of the wiper, that they oscillate between two extremes, right? So if I am taking the example of this car wiper, then it will be called as mechanism. If you consider a car, then that car will be a machine. Now we will see rigid body and non-rigid body. Now let us take a body, simple body, on which there are two points, A and B. And now we will apply external force on that. Let's say the distance between A and B is 5 units. Now after applying external force, this body will displace from one point to another point, let's say final position. But the point here I want to make is the distance between A and B, these two points, is same, or it is constant, and it is again only 5 units. So whenever these things happen, we will call that body as a rigid body. Now we will see this in a definition. A body is said to be a rigid if under the action of external forces it does not suffer any distortion. Distortion means change in shape, right? Or the distance between any two points on it remain constant. Now in this example, we have seen a body in which the distance between A and B was constant under the action of external forces. Now we will see, is there any body in which distance changes or there is some distortion or shape change occurs upon the external force? So we will see that. So here in this body, we are taking a spring. On that, let's say the fixed part is A point and this point is B right now. Okay. So whenever there is the external force, if we apply tensile load on this spring, so the distance between A to B will be changing to A to B dash. That means there is a distortion or there is a shape change in this body. Therefore, I will call this body as a non-rigid body, right? You can see in this definition, distance between any two points is not remaining constant or it is changing. Therefore, it is a non-rigid body. Now we will see what is the difference between rigid body and resistant body. So we have seen in the previous slide that what do we mean by rigid body, right? In a resistant body, this is the example of resistant body. You can see a chain drive, right? The motion is transmitted from one shaft to another shaft through a chain, right? So why I am calling this as a resistant body now? Because if we want this chain to be rigid, then it will be rigid under the action of tensile force. And if I want it to be flexible, now what do I mean by flexible? You can see over the pulley, it is easily bent and it easily turned and going and changing its direction. So that means whenever we want a link to be flexible, it is flexible. And whenever I want that link to be rigid, then it is rigid. So therefore, I will call such bodies as a resistant body. Again, there are few similar bodies like this chain. You can see a belt over here. Again, the belt is rigid under the action of tensile load, but if I want that to rotate on a pulley or bent on a pulley, so it will easily turn. Right? So these two are resistant bodies. So we will define it now. Resistant bodies are those which are rigid for the purpose they have to serve. So what is the purpose here of these two bodies? That means when I want these to be rigid under the action of tensile load, I want that bodies to be rigid. Now, a belt is rigid when subjected to tensile forces. Therefore, a belt drive acts as a resistant body. Another example of resistant body is fluid, which when compressed, as in case of hydraulic press, that means whenever we compress the fluid, then that will act as a rigid body. Right? Generally, resistant bodies are usually referred to as rigid bodies only. There is a very little difference between these two. Now we will see how fluid is an example of resistant body. Resistant bodies means what? They are rigid for the purpose they have to serve. Now what is the purpose of this fluid over here in this example? You can see we are applying a force on piston 1 and that motion is transmitted from piston 1 to piston 2. Through which link? Through fluid. That means now fluid is helping us. Fluid is acting as a link. Right? So therefore we are calling fluid here as a resistant body. Next is kinematic link or simply link or element. Now first of all we will see what is the definition. A link is defined as a member or combination of members of a mechanism connecting other members and having motion relative to them. That means if we see the example, now here you can see different parts of this slider crank mechanism. I will first of all tell you different parts. This is the crank which is rotating. You can see this as a disc. Then a connecting rod, which is a connection between slider and a crank. And then there is a fixed link, which is not at all moving. So basically there are four links. Now why I am calling them as a kinematic link? Because these are all members of a mechanism and which is helping others to move. That means there is some relative motion between them. Between crank and connecting rod, between connecting rod and slider, between slider and a fixed link, which is a guide. Right? So schematically, if I want to represent a slider crank mechanism, I will represent it as this. This is also called as a line diagram. So here you can see a frame which is fixed, then a crank which will rotate 360 degree, connecting rod which is our third link, and the fourth link is the slider which will slide. Right? Now we will see classification of kinematic link. First one is rigid link, then flexible link and fluid link. We have already seen what do we mean by rigid link. Flexible link, you can see some similarities between flexible link and a resistant body. Here the belt is considered as flexible link because it is flexible. We can easily turn it on a pulley. Third one is fluid link. One of the example of fluid link which we have already seen in the previous slides. Now we will take another example. We will take the example of brake. Now if we apply foot lever, that means we are applying some motion or force to this foot lever, then the brake fluid is pressed against the disc. Now you can see how this brake fluid is transmitted ahead, and that motion is provided to the brake calipers, and that brake calipers are pressed against this disc, and ultimately this disc is connected to the wheel. If the disc is stopping its motion, then wheel will also stop its motion, right? So this is the example of fluid as a link, right? Links can be also classified depending upon the ends on which turning pairs can be placed. Now what do I mean by that? Now first one is binary link. Now why I am calling this as binary link? Because you can see here on this link there are two ends, or I can say that these are two nodes wherein I can connect two links, on one on the right side, one on the left side. Therefore I am calling this as binary link. The next type of kinematic link is ternary link. Now why I am calling this as ternary link? It is very easy. You can see three nodes or three corners wherein I can connect three more links to that. Therefore it is ternary link. And final one is quaternary link. That means there are four corners or four nodes wherein I can connect four more links to these, right? For watching, kindly like, comment and share this video, and also subscribe to our channel. Thank you again.